When New College opened its doors to scholars in 1386, one of its many features was the magnificent kitchen. Probably designed by Hugh Herland, many of its original features remain, and although it still maintains its primary function for over 600 years, it's nonetheless a little too medieval for a modern college. The proposed alterations and restoration work will not only substantially improve the operation of the kitchen and the working environment for the staff, but also prepare the main structure of the building to face the next 600 years. But first, the college still needed to be fed and watered while the work was being carried out, and with only a 6-week period being available to set up the temporary facilities, there was no time to lose. One of the fundamental principles of the design brief was the removal of inappropriate materials, such as where lime plaster and mortar had been replaced with modern cementitious products. Nowhere had these materials been more inappropriate use than in the buttery, where a 125mm thick concrete levelling screed had been laid over a timber floor, part of which still had the original 14th century floorboards in place. To improve the operation of the kitchen, two lifts are to be installed to take the prepared food from the ground level up to the dining room on the first floor. But lifts need service pits underneath, and digging these out presented a whole set of challenges on their own.
We're from Oxford Archaeology. We're here excavating this trench where, as part of the kitchen refurbishment, they're going to be putting in some new dumbwaiter lifts. Because of its location just inside the medieval town wall, there's a high likelihood of us finding archaeology associated with the defensive circuit around the town. The wall that's here today is constructed in the 13th century, but it's on the site of an earlier bank which originates with the original town of Oxford, which is founded in the 9th century by Alfred the Great as part of a series of settlements along the boundary with the Danish occupation to the north. So we don't know an awful lot about the original defensive circuit, largely because where it has been seen, we haven't got an awful lot of dating evidence for it, which is why the date of the original foundation of Oxford isn't certain. So it's quite a rare opportunity to look at a 6-metre long section of that defensive bank. At the moment, we're excavating through what seems to be 13th century levelling deposits that have been dumped on top of the earlier bank. That could be associated with the construction of the town wall, but we're not absolutely certain yet. And underneath that, we seem to have what would be the probably late Saxon defensive bank. Now, it's further complicated then, because the original town, as I say, was founded in the 9th century, but there's a theory that it was originally a lot smaller and then it's extended in the 11th century. If that is the case, then the likelihood is we're within part of the 11th century extension. So, to summarise, we might have the 9th century circuit or the 11th century extension, which is then overlain by 13th century levelling deposits associated with the construction of the wall. And then you probably have occupation on top of that, but we haven't got any evidence for it here. And that's pretty much where we are at the moment.
While conservation repairs were carried out to the roof and chimneys, a temporary overroof was to be installed to provide protection from the weather. Within hours of this being complete, it was subjected to 70 mile an hour winds and the wettest winter on record. When designing the kitchen, it was important that the floor was level with the ancillary areas, such as the freezers and stores, which had not been the case for some time. This meant that the existing floor slab had to be broken out and reduced down by approximately 300 millimetres. Large deposits of asbestos were found underneath the slab, resulting in much of the reduced level dig being carried out as a full asbestos removal operation. Although the roof coverings are not yet complete, the building is now watertight. Having the full over-roof scaffolding in place is beginning to have an impact on following operations, and in particular, the foundations of the new extension. By taking off the roof section, the buttress scaffolding can now be removed, which will allow access to the next phase of work.
When we came here 2 years ago, the start of this project, it was never going to be an easy project. It was always going to be very complicated, and especially so given the historic nature of the building. And because it's a kitchen project, a modern kitchen needs so many modern services to make it function, apart from complying with sort of modern regulations and so forth. These services take up a phenomenal amount of room, which we hadn't got. And one of the key issues has been integrating those services within the historic fabric of the building. And an awful lot of that has been done with using underground ductwork through most of the usable areas of the college, particularly right through the middle of the kitchen into the undercroft. And I think this has been very successful because now you walk those areas and they are probably some of the most historic parts of the college. And virtually no services are visible, and I think that's something that was most important that we achieved, and I think we did that quite successfully.
Most of the challenges for our company working on the site have been it's all been hand dig. We couldn't get any machinery in through the doors or through any openings, so a lot of it's been literally a cango, shovel, barrow, and filling skips. You know, we've had over some weeks 20 skips a week. And filling them by hand, you can imagine, it's quite a job for five or six men, non-stop every day. But there's been different challenges all the way along. We found an old safe that they thought was in the building, and we had to work around it with Mark, the engineer, to find problems to solving it, to filling it with concrete. So pretty much all the job's been a challenge so far, and we're just getting to the point now where we're putting things back. So from my point of view, it's all going well and we're up to scratch where we need to be. So fantastic.
Most of the work has exceeded my expectations. There have been bits of the work, bits of the works that we've got to where things have had to be put right, dismantled, remade. It's not normally been a quality issue. It's normally been a practical problem. But the room we're sitting in has new wainscoting and new servery, and the level of care and quality of the work in this room has exceeded my expectations completely. I mean, the panelling at the end of the room is remarkable, I think, in what LOL has managed to has achieved with that. And the same goes for quite a number of the other things, where the result has really been has been quite outstanding. Certainly, the buttery again, the buttery has been transformed by this by the works on this occasion. The rest of the SCR, in one sense, looks pretty much the same, despite the fact that everything's been changed, altered, and refinished. I mean, on a sort of more design and aesthetic note, I mean, the new fireplace in the non-smoking room has exceeded my expectations in change that it's made in the scale of the room. It's been a big improvement.
I think probably one of the most satisfying aspects of it is now seeing these areas in use. The area that springs to mind particularly is the North Undercroft and the bar area. The North Undercroft area before we started was a pretty awful area really. It was full of little toilets, shower areas, staff rooms, which we just sort of gutted basically and took it back to the basic shell. And it's the basic shell now that, that actually really provides the character for that area of the site. Again, there's an awful lot of state-of-the-art services gone in there. They've got full theatre surround sound in there, interactive TVs. That area will basically do anything now that it wants. And it's good, like, obviously, we've still got a presence here doing bits and pieces and snagging works at the moment. But to see how that area is being used and the feedback that you get off the students for that area of the Undercroft as a study area and the bar as a social area, it seems to be an absolutely roaring success.
Really love the accommodation. It's very kind of well equipped and cosy compared to other my room last year. Like, all the furniture works together and I like that it's all fitted. I feel like it feels very well thought out for what a student needs.
I think the one thing that is now clear about this project is that it will be some time before we need to have an overhaul on the scale. The difficulty always is that because it's in every part of the college is in constant use, it's very hard to have this level of access that we've had over the last couple of years to be able to achieve things. Everything otherwise has to be sandwiched or into small areas carved out during the year, and those projects are difficult to manage, very bitty, very untidy. And I think at the end of this project, we can be sure that we're not going to have to do that type of work again for the foreseeable future.
That sense of history, you know, from when the college was founded back in the 14th century. Particularly, the thing that always impresses me with the main kitchen area is the fact that that was the kitchen when the college was founded. And it's still the kitchen now, sort of 600 plus years later. And that continuity of function is quite an amazing thing. And it's nice to think that you've played your part in that. And the works that we've done is like sort of set the old girl up for the next 100 years, as it were. And it's very satisfying to have been a part, even if it's a sort of drop in the ocean in its total history, but to have been a part of that is quite a special feeling, really.